Hi guys. So we will start. Does anybody knows what is this app live reviews means? Did you already seen that? People raise your hand if you know this concept. Okay. The idea of this that we had a bunch of applications that people, that developers send us. Thanks to them, really. That's a nice material to work on. And the idea is that all these GDEs around me doesn't know this app. They never open it in their life. And they will discover it with you. And what they will do is that they will leave the first user experience of this app and they will review it. They will tell what they think, what they feel, and how to maybe try to improve according to their feedback and what they are feeling. Okay? So we will try with the first application, which is Kilometer. Is Pierre, the developer of this application, in the room?
Yes.
Come on stage.
Okay. It had to be you.
So, Pierre, thank you, man. That will be very kind. The idea is being nice and having fun all together, okay? No joke, no silly things, okay?
Wait, we have to be nice?
We didn't sign up for that.
Don't beat me, please.
Okay.
Be kind.
So, David, just start. Use the application and everybody can watch it and tell us if they think something about it. Ooh. Okay. So you're watch opening back. The app. Do you, if you speak, do we hear you?
Yeah.
Okay, that's perfect.
I just saw fat.
Maybe Pierre, you can just give a small context of this application. What is the purpose?
It tells you how much fat you lose with your daily activities, like bicycle, walking, and so on.
Okay, perfect.
So you're going to go ahead.
So yeah, there is an authentication phase.
Can we zoom out a little bit on this so that we can see the top and bottom?
Sure. Oh, sorry.
Genymobile.
Ah, yeah. I forgot to tell you something, guys. One rule for this demo: it's never the Genymobile's fault. Okay. Yeah. I forgot that. Sorry. Okay. So it's connecting to Google Fit, right?
I think there's no internet in there.
Are you connected to internet?
I should.
It's not Genymobile. I think the internet doesn't work in your emulator.
Oh no! Actually, we are not.
Let's also see the top. So we can see if the status bar is transparent.
That's my fault.
If you don't have Google Fit on your device, you must download the API. So you must have internet.
That's fine. I just switched the Wi-Fi, so it should be good now.
It's a beta version. If there is a problem, it's the fault of Genymotion.
Can we just review Genymotion?
Okay, perfect. Just try to restart it. Maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, click connect now, no?
Okay.
Can we try to connect?
Yeah, sure. That's it. Okay. So.
Any motion?
It's a mystery.
Yeah.
What does this app do?
Yeah, you know, some assets just disappeared on the internet.
Yay.
Good.
Haven't done anything today.
So, do you guys have some things that you notice, things that you like, that you don't like for now?
Should this thing be here still?
No, I'm not colorblind, but in case someone is this a color scheme that works?
Of course.
Perfect.
No.
So the idea of onboarding somebody with a kind of a tutorial, you know, swipe to left navigation, is pretty interesting. You have the blue dots. You have the dots. Everything. Oh, this is interesting. So what's happening now? We have an ad.
Are you making money now?
No. Not yet.
I like the message though. I think it's nice.
Another thing that I think it's really personal, but for me, I really like to have a difference between the status bar, the nav bar, and the app. And right now, there is no contrast between your app and the system UI. So I would probably use a darker green for the status bar and the navigation bar at the bottom. But it may be personal because I like to have the difference between the content of the app and the system. I don't know what you think about that. Can we do a poll on this? Who's to have more contrast? So I have a darker status bar and a darker navigation bar.
Oh, wow.
So you do. I can ask for the other part.
Okay.
Thank you.
There is one thing I like on your application, and it means that it's really original. That's something that we don't used to see. That I don't know if you noticed, but actually he was swiping, and that because I already test some applications just to make sure that it's running and not crashing at the beginning. Sometimes it happens, right? I swipe, and I've seen an ad, like the second screen of the app. And then I swipe then another time, and there were this very clever message, hey, you know, there is some applications, but you can just for a few count to dismiss all this this advertising. And I think it's a pretty clever move to just introduce this nicely, because you did on a good way, because it was not so violent. That was on the tutorial process, so people can just dismiss it very quickly. But you imply the fact that people can just pay, or I don't know what they can do to dismiss advertising. That's a nice point for me.
You know, but I would contrast that a little bit and say I have, as a user, have not been convinced at all of the value of this application at that point in the process. So that I was already seeing an ad was a little off-putting.
Because I'm not
convinced. You know, why I'm using this. I'm just in the connect button at this point. Delaying that to a little bit later. Once you've got a little value out of your users and they can see why they would want to pay, would probably have a lot better retention and conversions.
Nice. Let's continue.
One thing that I thought when I first looked at this screen initially is that it all seems pretty flat to me. Everything is sort of on the same plane. So something I would like to see would be using a bit of elevation. Maybe that could convey some hierarchy. Because right now the buttons are all about the same level of importance as the main screen.
Yes. I did it the Microsoft way. Sorry. Just flat UI.
Microsoft way is best
measure,
way.
That way it's cool.
And I talked about the ad at the beginning, to be honest. I don't like the app that is very kind and sexy at the beginning, and the more you use it, the more you have ad. But maybe it's a clever way to make some money to do the ad when you have real results. I will make an A-B test, maybe.
So what's happening right now?
This is like a video game, right?
Yep. So you can swipe on this one too?
I'm not convinced that share icon is in a place that Google has been training us that share stuff exists.
Yeah.
And especially because it feels like we're swiping through things and it's at that same horizontal level. So it made me feel like the last page is going to be a share page rather than the share icon being somewhere on its own. And that kind of went with one of those previews that said, hey, you can share on the bottom. Well, if you kept it on the top, you wouldn't have to explain to people that it needs to be, you'll find the share on the bottom.
Okay, so where do you put it?
Ideally in an action bar or something that...
You can have
or
them
in,
up
a,
there,
in
right?
a toolbar or something that... So Google did a great job of training users that's where your actions will exist. So that you wouldn't have to explain it to someone of, oh, that's where all the actions on this page will be.
Even just for the touch space for this, you have like at the same, almost very close, like the menu button, then the swiping here, and then this icon, like too close, right?
It's an interesting point. I tried to make a new UI that is new to my app to be more sexy on the Google Play store. But I learned with UX experts that there is so many things that are new that people are confused. Why is the menu, why I must swipe, and so on and so on. So it's a lesson for me. I will try to be as sexy as possible, but to don't make new UX things that disappointed the user. And it's very difficult.
And actually, what I notice here is that actually this is the home of your application, the menu.
No.
What is the home exactly of this application?
The main menu. And click again.
Oh, home.
It's another problem I learned when I show my app to users. When you swap an app for every people on Android, it's an introduction. And not the home of your app. So it's confusing people a little bit at the beginning of the app. I hope it's not too confusing, but it's a problem.
A good thing for your... Sorry, go ahead.
I wanted to comment on the menu a little bit more. With this hierarchy, I think an up button would be a great opportunity to use a familiar user experience navigational flow for users so that they could go back up to home. But by keeping the menu down there and kind of going back to the point of non-standard navigation and user experience, users have a lot. Them having to learn your UI is like the least thing they care about. They have tons of different apps on their device that they may be trying. So it's already, you're very lucky that like a user has even installed your app and gotten this far. So by reducing the mental overhead that they have, it's much better to... it'll be much more likely that they will stay with your app versus potentially using a competitor at this point.
I've seen this a lot where apps want to bring something new to their app, and that something new is often navigation. And unless it's a fundamental part of the interaction of the app, I usually encourage people to save their innovation for something that's completely unique and essential to their app. So unless the way that they input their data is to swipe, I would say. Maybe say with a bit of a more standard menu and navigation. Also, you'll get your space back on the bottom.
The keyboard. The keyboard is physical here. So it's my... I know I will have to reboot something, so maybe not there.
Genymotion is great.
Genymotion. Help me.
You don't need it, man. do you have something to say, Cyril?
No, it was exactly what.
Hey, okay. Could we actually pop this app into airplane mode and then rotate it?
No problem.
Yeah, I'm a man after my heart.
It doesn't rotate. Genymotion?
Okay, that's okay. Now, I have one feedback about what your application is providing. Yeah, the idea was to measure the consumption of people, something like that, right?
It's a variation of Google Fit. You have instead of giving calorie
steps and so on, I tried to make something that is original. So I'm talking directly about fat.
Okay, and that's good. But if you look at your home, I didn't see any fat information on it. And that should be interesting to have your application have the main thing that it does. It provides fat information, but I don't see it on the home. And having it obviously displayed should be, in my point of view, pretty interesting because that's the thing your users are expecting from your application. That's the main thing they are expecting.
Yes.
And it's not on the home.
Like maybe you could have like pre-filled data before you import somebody else's profile. Just have something in there so the user can see what will be the end result of what your app is offering.
You think the fields are not there is no data in the fields at the beginning?
No, what I would say is if you're going to have, like, how are you going to show afterwards? Do this analysis thing you say, there's nothing, we don't have anything because there's no data about you. So something here say, we know that it's the first time you're using it and show some pre-populated data. So I know what you're going to show here in the once.
It's complicated because the user can install the app and so install Google Fit for the first time, so you have no data to deal with. So I must give sexy the information at the beginning, but I have no much information. It's the tough part of the app. I must be sexy at the beginning, and I don't have any data.
Placeholder data or showing the user potentially what it could look like will help train them such that when they come back later, they understand the potential value. They may use it more, and then
revisit the app at a later point, which is a problem you're going to have in general, that you need a user to continually come back to this so that they get more value. That's one of the hardest parts of an app in general. If, once someone has installed it, they will probably launch it, but getting a user to return to an app versus letting it stagnate is very difficult. So showing them what the potential value is probably not only a nice to have, but probably crucial so that they'll come back and look at it later.
So I guess we're going to switch to another app, but I just wanted to use
you
this.
You're tired of this app already?
No, but I just wanted to show you something about this screen. So because I've seen on a previous screen that you used a non-breaking space before the exclamation point. That's not the case in English, but it is in French, so please be careful with that. And go back to the advice analysis screen. I've seen that you've used the justified, which has been introduced in O. So for me, justifying text here is, well, it gives like the impression that the text is stretched. You know, there is huge gaps between the sorry and but and we. And personally speaking, I don't think justify is relevant on that kind of support. It's more accurate on print support, so like newspapers and stuff. But here I would only go for left alignment, I guess. It would be better. And remove those huge gaps between words.
Yes.
One last word. Your conclusion.
I know that I have no data at the beginning of the app, so I tried to say this, and you will see the point at the beginning. No activity today. Don't worry, we will notify you for the fast fat you'll burn. And this is the problem if the user uninstall the app, he will never have the notification that say you've burned your first fat and go to the sexy data. So it's one of the difficulty of the app. And so and thank you very much for the advice.
Yep. Just as something good, I really do like that you have the time that the app was updated. You may just want to work on, it feels like you're putting a sentence inside of there where you could have just been updated with a time. But it is really nice that I know when this app was updated when I open it.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks a lot, Pierre. That's really, really great. Yeah, good stuff. You know, that's very, 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 very hard as a developer to be on stage with these six animals telling about your app. So yeah, thanks a lot, Pierre. That's great. Okay. Next application, Paulette. Where is Paulette team? Come on stage. We are nice. No, we'll be. We will be nice, I hope. Maybe not Cyril, but the other one. Cyril, just your turn. Oh, maybe you want to do the Android Maker app? No, you no, will no, lead Paulette, it? Paulette. Paulette? Okay, let's go. Okay, I let you open the app.
Before we open the app, first thing I want to call out is there's a couple app icons here that look heavily inspired by iOS designs. And before even ever getting into that, that seems non-standard for the platform. Yeah. So using those rounded corners on the edges kind of gives me that impression. I don't know how you guys feel about that.
Yeah, I agree too. And another point is that the name of the app is Paulette, and the icon is Paulette. It's like putting train in an icon of an app that says train. I mean, it's completely stupid. No, but here I would use rather the trot, for instance, and you know, because I know that Paulette, you can't do anything with that, especially if you want to stick to the guidelines of material guidelines. So maybe trying to use the trot would be better.
Yeah, also if you use the chart, then you can have an interesting and unique shape for the outline of your app, which will make it more recognizable.
Yeah, and actually the idea is to have a metaphor and the chart for, I guess the app is to do some polls.
Yes.
So the chart is probably a good metaphor for this.
Okay, do you want...
Okay, start the app.
Can you, yeah, no, just before, while you are starting the app, can you just give in one sentence the context of this app? Because that will be interesting for people in the room.
Okay, so just in few words, we think that polls, as we used to have them, are broken. We saw the Brexit or the Trump election recently that totally proved that the polls are broken. So we thought, like, for the presidential election that is coming very soon in France, we would go for something like crowd polling and trying to get as many intentions as possible And with that kind of distribution channel, such as Play Store or App Store, we could really leverage a huge crowd to get accurate polls, or at least try and predict a bit better what's going to happen during the next election.
Okay, so first thing, no launch screen. When I'm starting the app, I get a blank screen here, and I would probably prefer having a placeholder UI. So, like the
do you know anybody who might have given a speech about this, from which we could learn?
Another thing that I like is the animations. So I don't know what kind of what did you use?
It's Slotty.
Okay, Okay, it's really nice. Maybe I would only go for the animation only the first time I see the page, because if whenever I'm changing the page here, I get the animation, which can be kind of boring at the end. But just having it once would be great. Yes. So let's go to Paulette. Who will you vote for?
You can go ahead.
I don't know why there is a thumbnail. Maybe there is one image missing here. Maybe we have no internet connection. Maybe?
No. Okay. This bug is happening. That's true.
No. Okay. Because I would expect something here. I mean, just looking at this, it feels like it is a placeholder for the thumbnail. So yeah, maybe I would use the image of the candidates for this presentation.
Yeah, we were a bit scared of using the candidates' images, but we thought that would look like a placeholder, so it would give you the will to click, or at least a hint to tell you, hey, you can select one of the candidates.
And I wasn't sure if this page fully loaded or not. So I know that there was a loader icon when you clicked on the button and it went to the screen, but there was no feedback that the screen has finished loading. And especially with those placeholder images there, I kept waiting for something else to appear or something else to play.
Yeah, actually, as a placeholder, instead of so circle, that we are, it's a pattern that we all see for portrait and faces of people on the web and on mobile. Maybe a gray heart should be quite obvious, because that's, I love this guy. I will vote for this guy. So that could be a better thumbnail.
In addition, this is something I'm not sure I've ever recommended to an app, but it might be nice actually to add one screen or a very brief explanation what your app does and to whom it will be giving this information.
Yeah.
Just because, to come in and have a screen that's immediately like, okay, which candidate will you vote for? I'd be like, who are these people? Is this public? It might be nice to explain, this is what we do. We aggregate anonymously, and it's for this purpose.
Yeah, that's what we tried to do on the third slide that we didn't.
Distracted by the animations.
Yeah, because
they were too cute.
Exactly.
So make them less cute.
The animation here, once again, please don't redo it, because when I'm scrolling back to the top, I get the animation. And another tip, because I'm really much into details, so when you press here, then you don't see the thumbnail on the left, because the idea is always to use alpha, so you get this is black with alpha, a lot of alpha, so that when you press and you have the ripple after that below that, you can just see you can still see the thumbnail. Okay, so I just have to confirm, right? And this is the third screen. Okay.
What do you guys think?
Those are real results.
Okay. You can share. Okay. Can you click on the cross?
Yeah. One question. Why did you use the a cross rather than a back or an app? Sorry. In the toolbar at the top.
Because the screen is modal.
Okay.
And to me it looked. We tried to make this page the main one.
Okay.
So when you come back to the app, you can either change your vote or see the results. If you change the vote, then you go to the results, but you can also directly see the results.
Okay.
And to make the navigation a bit clearer, we thought it would be nicer to to use a close button rather than an up.
Okay.
I think that an up there would make more sense. X is usually used for multi-select or something like that to cancel out of an interaction that's going on. So that, and because no, this, while you imply that it's a modal to the user, it's taking up the full screen, so it just looks like something deeper in the hierarchy. Up would probably make more sense.
I have one more idea about the navigation. So it seems here that your main screen, your home screen, is actually the last screen of the tutorial. So I don't know if you're trying to avoid influencing people's vote by showing them the results first, but you could consider making the landing page, you know, the current places of the candidates, and then there could be a, you know, an action button to add your vote if you want.
You could,
and that way this wouldn't be a modal returning to the tutorial.
And I'd love to see actually different colors for these. It's great that you have whatever the totals are, but visually it'd be nice if it was different shades of green or different shades of something so that you'll be able to visually compare what the differences are between the candidates without really just doing it based on the lines.
Also, it looks like the talk about is actually a share. It launched a share intent when we clicked that before. So that's a little confusing with that icon and the talk about. Is it like an internal forum that's being used or what's going on? So I would use a standard shape for that.
Okay, I think we are good on this review. Thanks a lot again. And I wanted to give you a special thanks because the Paulette team translated the application yesterday to make sure that all our GDEs will be able to read it in English. So thanks a lot, guys. Really, good job.
Thank you very much.
I did like the caricatures at the bottom.
Okay, so now I will call on stage four people that you must love, because that's four organizers that work on Unreal Makers. So please welcome on stage Stan, Benjamin, Adrien, and Javan, guys. We will review the Unreal Maker application that you are maybe all using for these 2 days. I want to give you a context of this application. I didn't work on that. And so that's the reason why it's working, really. But they did that in something like 2 weeks from scratch, right? Is that true? Something like that. And they were four working on that during the night. So they did a great job at releasing it with all these features. And Cyril, as you asked to review this app, I let you to lead this application.
Hey, before you open it, could you look at the app size?
Of course.
Yeah. Yes, interesting please. Point. No, you're right. Oh. Well, maybe I could, yeah. Yeah, I can. It'd be easier.
So for me, who was traveling internationally and on an edge connection.
It is. Yep. Apps. Android Makers.
I was actually blown away that it's only 2 megabytes for
yeah,
the app.
Which only 2 megabytes.
All of our international users, really, thank you.
Yeah. Okay, so here, once again, no launch screens, but it has been fixed. The good. by me. Okay, so I guess everybody knows this app, so I don't know. No. So yeah, there was one point here that I told to Stan, but so here we have like a checkbox. So in general, checkboxes are used for multiple selections. And in this case, actually, if you try to select another option, it actually unselect the previous one. So it's rather normally a radio button that you should use here. So like this dot. Because the first time I used that, yeah, I was like, what happened? I wanted English and French, but actually it was like an exclusive choice. Oh, yeah, but another thing that, yeah, maybe you've noticed that the program actually, the schedule is actually automatically scrolled to the current session. So for instance, I just opened the app and right now we are focusing on the app live review by GDEs and also Le Route, un inconnu chez soi. It's fine, like the time is related to the system time. Like says 7 a.m. Oh,
yeah. Exactly, yeah.
Yeah, there is a problem. Maybe Genymotion, no? there time zones and stuff.
It has to be Genymotion.
There is one thing I wanted to point out just about the very beginning launching of this app. For some reason, I fixate on empty states, and I've noticed that this one doesn't seem to have a pure loading state, only an error state and a full state. So when you first load it, it initially says there's nothing to show, but it's loading. So yeah, you see it just a flash, and then you get you forget about it because they load, which is great. But just to point out, there should probably be a separate loading state also.
Yeah, basically with that, we use Firebase, and we don't know exactly when the data has been loaded. So basically, we wait for 3 seconds. We don't have any data in 3 seconds. Yeah. We just display kind of error message, just say, wait. And at some point, data just arrived, so we can update the screen.
One thing that would be beneficial on the first screen where it has the full agenda is you have the three columns at the top to indicate the rooms, but then you additionally have color schemes in the three columns. But because you have this selection between French and English, I think it would make more sense to use the GPO color
profile,
or some sort of tag in the first UI to indicate the colors or indicate the language.
Yeah, makes sense. We wanted to put a category of the talk, like if it's talking about design and everything, but actually we didn't categorize the talk, so it was a bit harder. So we just picked the color by the one.
Yep. And if we go back to the, I guess, the main screen.
So I will explain you. Now, these kind of measures cannot be relevant on Genymotion because we are that's true. We are rendering. We are rendering. You see all these orange parts is the rendering that is happening outside the Android OS. That's because of the Android emulator's architecture. So this part of the graph is not really relevant for this review. Sorry, guys.
Can we go back to the agenda?
Of course.
So what was a little confusing for me is I felt like the times did not match up on the left to when the sessions were starting. So the only way I can tell when the session's actually starting is by going into it and seeing its detail. It would have been really nice if instead of going hourly, it would have been whatever the actual schedule is of the conference so that I can at a glance see this is when the next sessions are starting.
Yeah, it's kind of... It would be easier if it was all the same time for the session, but because we have a session with 25 minutes, it's kind of hard to put every 25 minutes, but maybe like a little ticker or something.
Right, or yeah, maybe in each of those rows, just have something in the background that would have shown where it's starting, yep.
Another thing that looks weird here is that the title in the toolbar is actually the same as the one in the content of the screen, so I would rather either use like a larger toolbar, like a double height toolbar, or just, I don't know, put another title like description of this talk and then have the description of the talk.
Image of the talk of the speaker.
Okay.
Yeah, we wanted to make a header, but
we made this view a bit quickly, and the thing is, we thought of putting some kind of icon for the type of presentation, like UI, UX, and stuff like that, a bit like the Google I/O app, with a coordinator layout and really cool stuff. But we didn't took time to do it, so yeah, it's a bit rushed, and it will be improved for the next time. it can be improved.
Could you press the star up top? Are you logged in right now?
I haven't done anything to be logged in. I guess it's completely local, right?
Yeah.
Oh, perfect. Awesome.
That's really strange. So I did something where I was sitting in a session and I'm just like having bug reports now, but I was sitting in a session. I tried to favorite my first thing to say, I'm going to come to this. And it launched a Google login. And then when it couldn't log my Google account in, it failed to favorite the session. I sat here trying over and over to favorite the session. Is that possible?
With your Google login?
With, yeah, no?
it's well. We are not using.
Yeah, one thing is that all these applications are just fresh installs.
You know what happened? I've been to so many conferences in the last week and mixing them up.
That's a direct contour in Abbey.
One last thing.
Yeah. Last comment, and then we switch.
One last thing that I've seen quite a lot on apps. So starting, I guess it's Lollipop or Marshmallow. I don't remember. We have this new recent menu where you have like the color of the toolbar that is used for each thumbnail. And generally speaking, when you use like the primary color in a toolbar, you also use this primary color in your icon. So as you can see here, there is no background protection for this icon, so we get blue on blue. And you can actually change or use a different icon only in that situation. And that's called activity manager.task description or something like that. So you can change the title and you can also change the color of the header if you want. So in that case, I would expect having like, I don't know, either a shape version of the icon or probably a white background that could protect, you know, the icon from the header color.
Or a secondary blue.
Or another color, yeah.
Just one question about that. So you just favorite the streamline right now? Just here. Don't move. Don't move. Come back.
Okay.
I say don't move.
This one?
No. Come back to the agenda.
Okay.
Again. So when you select a talk, obviously we didn't have any talk selected, so everything was full alpha, no alpha at all.
Yeah.
And now we just put alpha. I don't know if it's the best way to select something.
Yeah, for me, it was pretty obvious. When I done that for the first time, it was like the one with full opacity was definitely the one that I favored. Yeah.
We won't have the time to do another app, so you can just finish with this one, and then we will close the session.
I guess we're finished.
You're finished? So we can be early leaving this session, if you want. But if you have other comments, guys, just let us know.
Can we just make another app?
No, we have only 5 minutes, so the intro will be. You want to do it in 5 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do it.
Quick and dirty.
Okay, so thank you. Thanks a lot, guys. Thanks a lot for all the things you did. Vid Dressing is the developer in the room. Please run on stage.
As he's coming up, so I see that this is a shopping app. To me, people do shopping at home, so I think this one's much more important that it will work in tablet and will work in landscape. I can just see my wife sitting on the couch using this and wanting to do it on a tablet. So let's get a little rotate going.
No.
And
yeah.
Genymotion again.
Good, she'll buy less stuff.
I don't know if it's just my perspective right here, but these icons look so large to me.
Yeah,
is it just me?
Yeah, which I think they're bigger.
Yeah. I would think I would expect a more standard icon size.
The icons on the toolbar?
Yeah.
Yeah, they are big like that. It's on purpose.
I would recommend using the standard size, again, to keep the mental overhead of users low so they have a common user experience.
Okay.
You can talk about that.
Yeah.
Well, So here we switch from the normal context to a search context, and there is no really transition between those two contexts. So I would expect like a ripple effect or circular reveal or whatever, but something that really described what happened when I clicked on the magnifying glass. So just like I guess we have that on the Play Store, so just have to reveal the toolbar in the search mode. That would help the user understand how he switched from one context to another, from this context to the search context.
Okay, so what you mean, I can use some kind of animation like on the Gmail apps, like that?
Yeah. Well, actually, Gmail is really a simple one, it's just fading. Doing reveal would be better, I guess, because you really have like this impression that you have like, it starts from the magnifying glass and then expands to completely fill the toolbar.
Okay.
Which is better than Gmail.
Hello.
Like the style.
You like the colors?
That gray on black might be a little hard to see for vision impaired people.
Yeah.
You might have a little more contrast there.
And why have you chosen to use
accessory disclosure button like this, like for new in, woman, you have like arrows instead of icons?
Here we use the arrow just to tell the user that when he click on these items in the menu, he will go to another page.
Okay.
It's like just a kind of indicator.
Okay.
The carrot itself is a common iOS pattern, and in the Android design guidelines, it explicitly has something against using the carrot on a list item. So you might find another way to indicate that that's actionable.
Yeah, and especially on iOS, when you do have that, normally you have like a sliding effect.
Please don't do this.
Keaton just died.
I'm not about to.
I'm going
to
pretend I didn't see that. I was coming to tell you something nice, which is that I like I like that you've peaked the content on this page to indicate the user can swipe. That's nice. You didn't have to call it out. They can just look at it and tell that you can swipe to more content. What I would be curious is, will it still have that bit of a peak? What is going on?
Oh, that expands.
I was questioning will you still have a bit of a peak if it comes to a tablet, but it seems that we haven't got there.
Yeah. Like maybe you want to have this icon also pointing down so they know that it's going to expand. Like if you click on this and then it expands and then disappears.
Sorry?
Like having the same arrow that you have pointing towards the top also pointing towards down so we know that this is going to expand.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, this is weird.
Yeah, because right now when you're clicking on this, you don't know that it's going to expand something. So having the icon would help the user to understand that.
Are you talking about the animation?
It's more like an affordance to better understand what's going to happen after clicking. Just like you put arrow on the menu.
Okay.
Another thing is when the touch state is happening, it looks a little off. It looks like it's bottom aligned, where the row has a lot of height above it. You might think about centering those inside of their view. Do a vertical centering.
But in general, what I like with this application that it's pretty slick. Yeah, if there is like a notion of air, you know, it's not like a lot of content. You can really browse it and breathe, because a lot of apps are like too much content, and this one is pretty great for that.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, guys.
Can we buy one? Review.
So I hope you liked this session. The idea was to have fun. We had some, and with a few advices from the GDEs. See you very soon on other sessions. And now that's the next one.